In case you don't want to install Joomla with a script, you can also install it manually. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can install Joomla manually without using the script. You'll first need to log into your cPanel. I have already opened the cPanel here. You will need to create a MySQL database and password. To do that, I'll be typing in MySQL in the search box and go to MySQL databases. Now, first of all, I'll need to create a database. I'll be creating a new database by typing in the database name. For now, I'll name it as DATABASE, that is database, and create database. Now, you will see that a new database, ihrayu_database, has been created. I will need to copy this and paste it to a notepad so that I can access it later. So here is my notepad, I'll just paste it, or else you can use any text editing app to do this. Now you will need to create a MySQL user. You will need to click go back and then go under create a new user, which is here. Now I'll add a new user. I will name it user and I will need to type two passwords. I will use the password generator for this. Copy the generated password, tick this and use password. You will see that the password has been pasted two times here automatically. I will open up my notepad, paste this and call it MySQL database user password. And then the username is ihrayu_user. I'll be needing this when I will install Joomla. I'll create the user by clicking create user. Now you will see that a MySQL user has been created. I'll click go back to go back to my cPanel. Now the main thing I need to do is add user to database. You can do this by scrolling down and going to add user to database section. Here you'll need to select the user which you just created, which is ihrayu_user. Select the database which you just created, that is ihrayu_database, and click add. This page will ask you what privileges you want to give to the user so that he can alter the database. Now I'll just generally select all privileges and click make changes. Now you will see that ihrayu_user, which is a MySQL database user, has been added to database ihrayu_database. Now click go back to go back to your MySQL databases and then click home to go back to your cPanel. Now what we need to do is download Akiba Kickstart. You can do this by opening a new tab and going to your joomlatutor.com/kickstart and then hit enter. In the page that loads, go to the latest version and take me to download to this version. Click this. In this page you will see an option to download it. Click the download now button and save it anywhere in your computer. Once the file is downloaded, you need to go back to your cPanel and click on this file manager. I want to install Joomla under my add-on domain, which is iakashlal.net. I'll be opening up this add-on domain to show you that it's currently blank. Yes, it is blank. And this domain is loaded from my hosting, which is here. As you can see, this directory is empty, so this website is also blank. Now I'll upload Kickstart over here by clicking this upload button. I'll choose file and choose Akiba Kickstart, which is here. And then the uploading will start automatically. Once the uploading is done, you can close this. After uploading Kickstart code, you will first need to extract it. Right click on this and click extract. Then click extract files. Once this is extracted, you will need to delete the main file you downloaded, which will be kickstart core 411.zip. just delete this by right clicking, delete, skip thrash and thrash files. Now once you have come to the screen, open up your site, put a forward slash, type in kickstart, add a period and type in PHP and click enter. Now you will see that the kickstart has been loaded. You can click close this message and click import from URL. Now you will need to put in a URL to latest Joomla. You can click this button. Sometimes if this doesn't work, you'll need to go to joomla.org. This is the CMS which we are going to use to build a website. I'll click download and then right click, copy link address, and I'll paste it here and then click import from URL. You'll see that this file will be downloaded and uploaded to this, to our main site through Akiba Kickstart. Now you will see that the import is complete. You will need to click reload Kickstart and press escape or just close your message. Now choose, go here and choose directly. Now go here and click start. Now click run the installer. From here starts the main Joomla installation. You can enter your site name. For now I'll be entering my marketing website. For the description, I'll enter my site description, that is taking your marketing to the next level. For admin email, I'll be entering my email. I'll be entering our admin username and I'll be entering our admin password. I'll also need to confirm it. After inputting all this information, click next. Now you will see that Joomla is asking for your database details. For this, you will need the notepad file which I had already created in the last step. I'll copy the, pasting it here. I'll copy the MySQL database user password, paste it here, copy the username and paste it here. Now you can leave this as backup or else you can also choose remove. If you already had a site and you want to retain the contents, click backup and then click next. You will now get an option to choose if you want sample data or not. I'll leave it at none. Then email configuration. If you set it to yes, then you will get an email with your username and password. I'll just set it to no for now because I already have my email and password. Then you can leave this as it is and then click install. Joomla will be installed on your server and you will see an option to remove installation folder. You will need to do this else your site is at risk. So I'll click remove installation folder. Now after the installation folder has been removed, I can open the administrator area as well as my main site. As you can see, my main site has been created and admin area. I'll input my username and password. And click login to login to my administrator backend. That's it. In the next lecture, I will show you how you can install a marketing extension, make landing pages that collect leads, and you can automate your marketing using email autoresponders and scheduled emails. See you in the next lecture.